In this video, I'm showing you everything you need to know about the tone curve in Lightroom. It's gonna be good. My name is Pi, and I'm one of the founders of Lynn and Jersa Photography and SLRLounge.com. We're teaming up with Adorama to bring you a new series of photography tutorials called Master Your Craft right here on Adorama TV. So let's dive in. What's up, my friends? My name is Pi. Welcome to Adorama TV. It is wonderful being back here with y'all. This week, we're all about the tone curves. So look, I'm gonna throw in here an exercise file. I'd love for you guys to download it, follow along. We're gonna be using Lightroom Classic, although everything we're gonna be talking about will also apply over to Lightroom Mobile as well as Lightroom CC. Let's go ahead and jump straight in. So number one, the point curve and parametric curve are completely independent. I'm gonna explain what that means, but see, I had to throw this deep one right into the beginning just to tell y'all that this tone curve tutorial is gonna be different from the rest. Now you know. Let's go ahead and show you what I mean. So inside of Lightroom, I have our exercise file loaded up. Now, when you scroll down to the tone curve, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. I'm gonna right click and go to solo mode, so that way we only see one panel at a time. Bet you didn't know that either. Right click, solo mode. Okay, so in the tone curve, we have the point curve, but if you look right next to it, we also have the parametric curve. These work differently and independently of one another. So the parametric curve, you're gonna be making adjustments based on regions, while the tone curve, you're gonna click on specific points on the curve and adjust accordingly. The beauty in this is that they're actually separate from each other. So I can make an adjustment here to the point curve, and then I can go to the parametric curve and I can actually make refining adjustments here by tweaking various things in these different regions, okay? I'm gonna go deeper into both of these, explaining them from the ground up, so don't worry. The first thing is simply to understand that they are two different functions that can be used independently, so you have two layers of control right here. Number two, the point curve as well as the parametric curve are essentially allowing you to control two things, exposure and overall contrast. Now I'm gonna show you exactly how it works. So let's go ahead and select the point curve first. I'm gonna press Control Shift R or Command Shift R to reset everything. So we go back to this base image. Now, just to have more image real estate, I'm gonna close down my preset panel for right now as well. So over here on the tone curve side, what you're gonna see is a mirror representation of the actual sliders in your basic panel, but it's shown visually with a graph. So what you see on the left side are blacks, and as you go towards the right side, this is shadows, and then you have midtones, then you have highlights, and then you have whites. So let's go ahead and turn off solo mode so we can open up the basic panel as well. And that's represented right here in your sliders. So look, we have blacks, we have shadows, we have highlights, we have whites, and exposure is essentially overall midtones, kind of bumping everything, right? So these are once again independent of the actual tone curve. So this is now a third layer of control right here between these two panels. So let me show you how it works with the tone curve. Well, when you're looking at the point curve, if you want to adjust exposure of something, so if I want to start in the midtones and adjust overall image exposure, I would click to add a point and then drag up to increase exposure or drag down to decrease overall exposure. If you click to add a point and you hold shift, you can constrain the movement to up and down movements as opposed to left, right, and everything else, okay? So if you want to just move up and down, you can click there. So if I want to adjust just the highlights, let's say I want to pull my midtones up and brighten the midtones, but I want to lower the exposure in the highlights, I can pull those down a bit to lower that exposure. Let's say I like the shadows, but I want to pull down a little bit to make the shadows a little bit deeper, I can do that as well. So you can control various points along this curve, adjusting exposure. Now, why do I say that you can also affect contrast? Because by targeting different places on your curve, well, you can affect the overall contrast in your image. So let's think about it this way. I want to reset this. I want to go back to the basic panel. If I raise contrast, what's actually happening here is that Lightroom or any image processing application, raising contrast means that you're making that stuff that's white more white. You're pulling it towards one side. You're making the stuff that's black more black. You're pulling it toward the other side. So you're basically pulling apart the tones, making whites more white, making blacks more black. That's how contrast works. So if we think about it from that way, we can do the exact same thing with a tone curve. I can make the whites or the highlights of the image more white. I can make the blacks more black. And what we've just done right there is add contrast. And in the same way, so look, if I create a virtual copy of this, this is kind of fun because you really get a dive into the nuance of this. I'm gonna press Control apostrophe or Command apostrophe. I'm gonna reset both these images by pressing Control Shift R. And watch, we're gonna select this one image first, and I'm gonna add 50 contrast, or maybe let's just go all the way to 100 so it's deeper, okay? Now I'm gonna go to the second image. I'm gonna raise my whites, okay? I'm gonna deepen my blacks, okay? Now look what happens. We've literally made the exact same. I was trying to approximate it, and I think I did a really good job. So that S curve approximates 100 contrast. So here we added 100 contrast. Here, we just made an S curve, which is a contrast boosting curve, okay? So it's identical. Now the beauty in this is I haven't touched contrast. So I could leave contrast for a final kind of tweaking adjustment as opposed to using contrast in the image to create it, if that makes sense. So this gives us layered control. And if you're designing presets, this is huge because if you're designing your own look, you want to have that layered control where you use different things to control different things. So for example, in Visual Flow presets, we leave contrast, exposure, and white balance up to the user to decide. Those are your fine-tuning adjustments. So we build in exposure and contrast adjustments into the tone curve. Okay, so we have that. Now, if I want to reduce contrast, watch this. I'm gonna reverse the curve. So a reverse S curve where we lift the shadows and drop the highlights is doing just that. We're reducing contrast. So watch, if I sit there and pull back contrast, that's exactly what's happening with the second image. So let's go here. Okay, this is negative 95 contrast. This is a contrast reducing tone curve. So that's exactly what's happening. Now, the way that these two things affect color are gonna be a little bit different. This is why I love using the tone curves for contrast and exposure because it has a more subtle hand, leaving and preserving original color tones compared to contrast or the contrast slider. So now you know how the tone curve works. You have a visual representation of shadows all the way to whites, and you're simply adjusting exposure up and down along this curve to control each of those section of tones. Let's go to number three. That matte look in an image is actually achieved with the curve. So watch, I'm gonna go with a standard contrast boosting S curve after I've made an adjustment to exposure. I'm gonna click right in the middle, hold down shift, drag up, and this is going to control exposure. I'm gonna bring the exposure to right about here. But look, I actually wanna flatten out some of the highlights a bit. So I'm gonna pull down the highlights a little bit. Okay, I'm also gonna pull down in the shadows a little bit to kind of flatten out this curve. Now, one suggestion is when you're making adjustments to your curve, you wanna keep the movements in this curve subtle, okay? So think of nice curvy movements, not sharp movements. If you make sharp adjustments to this, you're gonna end up with wonky color tones like what you see here. You wanna think of subtle, refined movements in that curve, nice flowing tone curves. Okay. So now, if I actually grab this endpoint and pull up, what you're gonna start getting is a matte look. See, what's happening is I'm telling Lightroom that anything below this point here, I want it to drop to a deep gray. Now on this side, I'm gonna tell Lightroom anything above this level of brightness, I want to go to a bright gray. So this is how we create that matte look in an image. And I can sit here and make kind of refinements to this. Okay, so I can pull down the exposure a bit. I can even soften the highlights. I can say, I wanna soften those highlights quite dramatically. Not too much where I get a little bit of posterization, but just a bit. I'm gonna pull down right here so that those whites go to gray. I'm gonna leave this mid-tone down a little bit, and I'm gonna now pull up on the matte effect while also bringing down my shadows to kind of make a deeper matte look. So this curve is a matte type curve. And if I turn this off, look at the difference in this kind of overall contrast and color grade. So I'm affecting everything in this image, contrast and all, as well as the black point and the white point with just this curve. This brings me to number four, use the parametric curve to refine. This is the beauty in having those independent layers. So now if I flip over to the parametric curve, I can actually change the feathering or the way that these points kind of move by adjusting these feather points. In addition, I can adjust each of those regions. So in the highlights, I can say, you know, those highlights are just a bit too much. I need to soften them a bit. I can pull down the highlights, I can pull down the whites and kind of get a softer overall tone. And what's happening, you can see, is it's manipulating the point curve that I've created with these regional adjustments. Then I can bias the feather to one side or the other to again further refine this. So I'm gonna pull this over to this side so I get a more subtle transition in those tones. Look at how the curve is taking a more subtle shape to it as I make these adjustments. So on the dark side, I can say, yeah, I want the darks to be a little bit darker and I want the shadows just to be a little bit raised, maybe up like plus 10, not too much, but right about here. So now using my parametric curve, I can make refining adjustments to the point curve. I would suggest using the parametric curve this way. First, dial in your primary settings with the point curve, then use the parametric curve to refine the overall tones and refine the shape of your curve. Last but not least, point number five, you also have RGB curves, which once again are independent from every other type of curve. So look at the curves right here. See how it goes red channel, green channel, blue channel. These are independent from both the point curve as well as the parametric curve. So I can use these channels to add or remove color from the image. And you're simply gonna think how you would like on a color wheel. So for example, if I want more warmth in my highlights, I need to add reds and greens to the highlights and remove some of the blues. So watch this. What I'm gonna do now is adjust the highlights up a bit. I'm gonna bring the red point up a little bit in the highlights and I'm gonna pull down in the midpoint because I don't wanna see those reds in my shadows. So I'm gonna pull down so I don't see those reds in the shadows. I'm gonna raise a little bit of those greens in the highlights so I have a little bit more of kind of subtle warmth to it, while also reducing the greens a bit in the shadows as well, okay? So I'm gonna go to about right here. Okay, now in the blues, if I remove blues from the highlights, it allows those reds and greens to shine through. So if we remove the blue, we start to see more yellow. So I'm gonna pull down the blues, and if I wanna leave everything with this kind of like subtle sort of yellow toning, I would leave it right there. But if I wanna add back a little bit of blues into the shadows, I can grab the shadows and pull up. Now I like that subtle look, so what you're gonna do is right click and delete the control point that I just created. And at any point in time, you can make individual adjustments by simply right clicking along the point curve. You can delete a control point. You can also reset the entire thing. You can snap to grid. I wouldn't recommend snapping to grids because it's gonna snap it and control your movements, but you can control and adjust any of those. These also work the same way. If you start to pull down the clipping adjustments, anything that's above a certain amount is gonna go to those colors, okay? So what I'm gonna do is just kind of find that subtle point here where I've kind of added a nice bit of warmth into my highlights, and I might just add a tiny, tiny bit of blues back into the shadows and call it good. Now, this is the crazy part about this, is with these adjustments, right? With all these adjustments, I have completely transformed the image. So if I turn this tone curve off, look at the raw file versus this image, where it looks like we added a full color grade. I haven't even touched any of these other sliders. Nothing else in Lightroom has been used. And the beauty of that is now you have each of these other controls to manipulate. You can sit here and layer all these different controls. So right now I can go back to temperature and be like, yeah, I want to add a bit of warmth over everything that we just did. And we get this nice warmth. I go, yeah, now I want to tweak and get a little bit more contrast in the image. I love where the highlights are. Maybe I'm going to pull down just a little bit to get a little more subtle highlights. Maybe pull down the white point just to get kind of, I don't want those super bright whites. Maybe raise a little bit on the shadows and drop a little bit in the blacks. And now I can use each one of these things to refine, going, I want a little bit more mid-tone contrast in the image. I love adding a little bit of dehaze just for a little extra contrast. And we're gonna pump up those color tones by putting a little bit more vibrance into the shot. Now, I'm gonna grab a radial filter. This is one of my favorite things to do. I'm gonna go to a burn brush and just drop it right over my friend James, okay? And just pull the attention right into him. I'm gonna do the same thing with a graduated filter right from the top, okay? And then I go, yeah, the image looks great, but it's a little bit too contrasty, so I'm just gonna back it off just a little bit. And boom, we have all these adjustments now layered in, and look at how much work the tone curve is doing. The tone curve is doing all the heavy lifting, and I love that because I can leave other things to do the subtle refinement. We haven't even touched HSL as well or calibration. So you have so much control over contrast and color by fully understanding the tone curve. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and if you did, I'd love for you to like the video, comment below, let me know what you think, let me know what questions you have. Maybe it'll become a future video. In the meanwhile, subscribe to the Adorama TV channel. I know it's crazy, but YouTube wants you to not only subscribe, but then turn on notifications. So they're like, yeah, I subscribed and it wasn't a mistake. That was a gigantic play. In the meantime, you guys can follow me at Born Uncreative on TikTok, as well as PyJirsa on Instagram. And if you enjoy our education and learning the why behind all these things, be sure to check out slrloungeworkshops.com for our professional education for photographers at all skill levels. See you guys next week. Bye.